A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. Random House Audio presents Star Wars Crucible by Troy Denning. Read for you by Marc Thompson. Chapter 1. With lowlifes of every species, from three-eyed Grand to four-armed Hecto standing belly to bar, the Red Ronto reminded Han Solo of that cantina back on Mos Eisley, the one where he had first met Luke Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi all those years ago. Smoke hung in the air so thick and green he could taste it, and the bartender was pulling drinks from a tangle of pipes and spigots, more complicated than a hyperdrive unit. There was even an all-Bith band on stage, though instead of upbeat jats, they were playing the room with outdated smazo. Usually the driving bass and stabbing whale horn made Han think of banging coolant lines, but today he was feeling it. And why not? This trip promised to be more getaway than mission, and he was looking forward to seeing his old friend, Lando Calrissian, again.
"I don't like it, Han," Leia said, raising her voice over the music. "It's not like Lando to be so late."
Han turned to look across the table, where Leia sat with a half-empty drink in front of her. Wearing a gray gunner's jacket over a white flight suit, she was, as always, the classiest female in the joint. And despite a few laugh lines, still the most beautiful. He thumbed a control pad on the edge of the table, and the faint yellow radiance of a tranquility screen rose around their booth. The screen was a rare touch of quality for a place like the Red Ronto, but one Han appreciated as the raucous music faded to a muffled booming.
"Relax," he said. "When has Lando ever missed a rendezvous?"
"My point exactly. Maybe that pirate problem is more dangerous than he thought."
Leia nodded toward the entrance.
"And take a look at that miner over there. His force aura is filled with anxiety."
Han followed her gaze toward a swarthy young human dressed in the dust-caked safety boots and Molotex jumpsuit of an asteroid miner. With a nose just crooked enough to be rakish and a T-6 blaster pistol hanging from his side, the kid was clearly no stranger to a fight. But he was not exactly streetwise either. He was just standing there in the doorway, squinting into dark corners while he remained silhouetted against the light behind him.
"He doesn't look like much of a threat,"
Han said. Still, he dropped a hand to his thigh holster and undid the retention strap. As a Jedi Knight, Leia felt things through the Force that Han could not sense at all, and he had long ago learned to trust her instincts.
"Probably just some crew chief looking for new hires."
The miner's gaze stopped at the Solo's booth. He flashed a brash smile, then said something to the bartender and raised three fingers.
"He's looking for us, Han," Leia said. "This must have something to do with Lando."
"Could be,"
Han allowed, but he hoped Leia was wrong. Missed rendezvous and strange messengers were never a good sign. Any lingering doubt about the miner's intentions vanished when the bartender handed him a bottle of Corellian Reserve with three glasses, and he started in their direction. There was something in his bold stride and cocky grin that set Han on edge.
"Whoever he is, I don't like him,"
Han said.
"He's way too sure of himself."
Leia smiled.
"He reminds me of you at that age," she said. "I like him already."
Han shot her a scowl meant to suggest she needed an eye exam, and then the newcomer was at their table, stepping through the tranquility screen. He placed the glasses on the table and opened the bottle.
"I hope you don't mind," he said, pouring, "but they keep a case of Reserve on hand for Lando, and I thought you might prefer it to the usual swill around here."
"You were right," Leia said, visibly relaxing at the mention of Lando's name.
Whom shall I thank?
The miner placed a hand on his chest.
Omad Keg at your service, he said, bowing. Captain Omad Keg, owner and operator of the Joyous Roamer, one of the oldest and most profitable asteroid tugs in the rift.
Han rolled his eyes at the overblown introduction, but Leia smiled.
It's a pleasure to meet you, Captain Keg.
She motioned at the table.
Won't you join us?
Keg flashed his brash smile again.
It would be an honor.
Instead of taking a seat where Leia had indicated, Keg leaned across the table to set his glass in the shadows on the far side of the booth, an obvious attempt to position himself where he could watch the door. Han quickly rose and allowed Keg into the back of the booth. If a stranger wanted to place himself in a crossfire zone between two solos, Han wasn't going to argue.
So, how do you know Lando?
Han asked, resuming his seat.
And where is he?
I know Lando from the Miners Cooperative. And, of course, I supply his asteroid refinery on Sarnas.
Keg's gray eyes slid toward the still empty entrance, then back again.
I think he's at the refinery now. At least, that's where he wants you to meet him.
Han scowled.
On Sarnas?
The planet lay hidden deep in the Chulun Rift, one of the densest, most difficult to navigate nebulae in the galaxy, and its actual coordinates were a matter of debate.
How the blazes does he expect us to find it?
That's why Lando sent me, Keg said. To help.
Keg's hand dropped toward his thigh pocket, causing Han to draw his blaster and aim it at the kid's belly under the table. He wasn't taking any chances. But Keg was only reaching for a portable holopad projector, which he placed on the table.
Let me show you what you'll be facing.
Why not?
Han waved at the holopad with his free hand. Keg tapped a command into the controls, and a 2-meter band of braided shadow appeared above the pad. Shaped like a narrow wedge, the braid appeared to be coming undone in places, with wild blue wisps dangling down toward the corrosion-pitted tabletop and even into Han's drink.
This, of course, is a chart of the Chulun Rift, Keg said.
He tapped another command, and a red dash appeared on the holomap, marking the cantina's location on Brink Station just outside the rift. The dash quickly stretched into a line and began to coil through the tangled wisps of hot plasma that gave the Chulun Rift its distinctive array of blue hues. Before long, it had twisted itself into a confusing snarl that ran vaguely toward the center of the nebula.
And this is the best route to Lando's refinery on Sarnas, Keg said. I've been doing my best to keep the charts accurate, but I'm afraid the last update was 2 standard days ago.
2 days?
Han asked. With 3 kinds of hot plasma rolling around at near light speed, hyperspace lanes inside the rift tended to open and close quickly, sometimes in hours.
That's the best you can do?
I'm sorry, but yes, Keg said. It's important to take it slow and careful in there. If you were to leave a hyperspace lane and punch through a plasma cloud, you would fry every circuit on your ship, including your navigation sensors.
You don't say,
Han said. Hitting a plasma pocket was one of the most basic dangers of nebula running, so it seemed to him that Keg was working way too hard to make sure he knew how dangerous it was to travel the rift.
Thanks for the warning.
No problem, Keg grinned,
then let his gaze drift back toward the cantina door.
Any friend of Lando Calrissian's is a friend of mine.
Instead of answering, Han caught Leia's eye, then tipped his head ever so slightly toward their table mate. She nodded and turned toward Keg. After 40 years together, he knew she would understand what he was thinking. But something felt wrong with Keg's story.
We appreciate your concern, Captain Keg.
Leia's tone was warm, but commanding, a sure sign that she was using the Force to encourage Keg to answer honestly.
But I still don't understand why Lando isn't here himself. When he asked us to look into the pirate problem in the Rift, he was quite insistent that he would meet us here at the Red Ronto personally.
Cage shrugged.
I'm sorry, but he didn't explain the change of plans. His message only said to meet you here and make sure you reach Sarnas.
Continuing to watch the door with one eye, he paused, then spoke in a confidential tone.
But I don't blame you for hesitating. This trip could be very risky, especially for someone your age.
Our age?
Han bristled.
You think we're old or something?
Keg finally looked away from the door.
No, he replied. It's just that, well, you do need pretty quick reflexes in the Chaloon Rift.
It's called experience, kid.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.